Welcome to example number 7, which involves a boat rowing across a river. So we have Jack that's rowing a boat across the river, and he points his boat at some angle in the northwesterly direction, such that his boat will continue to move actually relative to the shore in the due west direction. The water speed is given as 0.61 meters per second going directly south, and it takes Jack 4.2 minutes to cover this distance directly across of 250 meters. So let's start writing down some of our given. Now it would be good to establish, before we do the sketch maybe, what are the subscripts that we're going to be using. So we have a rowboat, so we'll use capital R for the rowboat. Okay, we have the shore, so I'll use that as S. That's basically the ground. All right, and then we have the water, so I'll just use a capital W for water. And if you look at the information, we have this speed of 0.61 meters per second. So 0.61 meters per second, and this is moving in the direct south direction. And that would be the velocity of the water relative to the shore. So if someone was standing here along the shore and observing the water go by, they would be seeing it going at that velocity. Now we are given some other information. We're given this displacement of 250 meters, so I'll just call that delta x, so it's, since it's along the x-axis, and we're given this time of 4.2 minutes. So I would imagine that we could figure out something here. If we were to take the displacement horizontally divided by the time, so that's 250 meters, but we probably want our speed to be in meters per second, so I would suggest that you change that minutes to seconds. So let's multiply by 60 seconds over 1 minute. It gives us a time of 252 seconds, so let's put that underneath here, 252 seconds, which gives us a speed of 0.992 meters per second. So what did we just find, by the way? Well, that was the actual path of the boat relative to the shore. So really, this is the velocity of the rowboat relative to the shore. And this is moving, by the way, directly west. So we really have two velocities. We have the velocity of the water with respect to the shore and the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the shore. And in this question, we're asked to determine what direction did he head his rowboat at, so we need to find the angle, and then what speed was the boat going with respect to still water. So we're asked to find the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the water. We don't know that, and we want to know the angle as well. So we need to organize these vectors into a vector diagram. So we have several vectors. We have the vector here that shows here. This is the velocity of the water. We have the boat that's actually angling off here. So there I've shown those two vectors. And we also have the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the shore, which is basically going directly this direction here. And I realized here that this is the actual velocity of the rowboat with respect to the shore, but this is actually the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the water. So make sure that you're getting your subscripts all correct here. So now I would organize these into a triangle now. And there you go, and I just changed the colors a little bit so you could see that. So we have the velocity, there's the rowboat going with respect to the water. There's the water pushing the rowboat downwards, and this is the result. What happens when you add these two vectors, this is what the rowboat follows this path with respect to, say, someone on the shore viewing this. So now we could write our three velocities in an equation. So we could write the velocity, this is the these two vectors here, add up to this vector. So the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the shore is equal to the vector sum of the rowboat with respect to the water plus the velocity of the water relative to the shore. Okay, and so you can see again it's following the subscript rules. Here you have W and W matching up here, R starting off here, S ending there in our equation. So to compensate basically for the water that is pushing him down southwards, he'll have to angle his boat in the northwesterly direction. So we're going to need to figure out this angle theta in here. So how would we figure out theta? Now remember, you do know some sides of this triangle. You know this side of the triangle right here, That's 0.61. And we calculated the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the shore, and that was 0.992. So we have these two sides here, which is the opposite and the adjacent, so we'll need to use tan. So to find the angle, we're going to use tan theta, which is opposite, so that's the velocity of the water with respect to the shore, divided by the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the shore. So that's going to be 0.61 meters per second divided by 0.992 meters per second. That gets us an angle of 31.6 degrees. And this is relative to the westerly axis. So this is north of west. So we just answered the first question about what direction did he head his rowboat to follow this due west course. And the last part we need to figure out is what is the speed that Jack is able to row at with respect to still water. So we need to find this velocity here along the hypotenuse. So we're going to use Pythagorean theorem. The velocity of the rowboat with respect to the water is equal to the square root of the velocity of the water with respect to the shore squared plus the velocity of the rowboat with respect to the shore, quantity squared. And so we're substitute in here. We have 0.61 squared plus 0.992 squared, and we're solving that. And we get a speed of 1.16 meters per second. So therefore, Jack rows at a speed of 1.16 meters per second with respect to the water. So that's it for example number 7.